I've joined it, and UKIP have joined it, and the exciting thing about Go is that we are a genuine cross-party movement of people who might not always agree on domestic policy, but are absolutely united in fighting to get back our democracy, to get back our liberty, our freedom of our nation. And our last speaker tonight, I think, very much proves that point. Our last speaker tonight, ladies and gentlemen, is without doubt one of the greatest orators in this country. He's a towering figure on the left of British politics, and he's coming onto this platform today to join the Grassroots Out movement. And I want you to give a very big, warm welcome to George Galloway.
Comrades and friends, first of all, I'd like to thank Nigel Farage very sincerely for his kind welcome, the more generous because Nigel and I agree on hardly anything at all. But we do agree at least on one thing, and it happens to be the most important thing, not only now, but in the lifetime of everyone in this hall and everyone in this country. It is the demand that Britain should be an independent, sovereign, and democratic country, and that means leaving the European Union. In this hall, as in this country, all of us will have different visions of what our country could be, should be. But the fundamental point is, none of us here in this hall, none of us here in this country are in a position to decide which vision of Britain should come to pass, because that power has been given away to a lavishly funded eurocratic state, to a toothless, fantastically financed pseudo-parliament, and to a council of ministers of countries which, to be fair, how could it be otherwise, act in their own national interests rather than ours. And that means that our independence as a country is no more, and we have an exit door, as Nigel just said, and if we don't take it, then we and our children and their children will lament and regret that we did not take that opportunity, which now comes before us on the 24th of June. I wanted to be here to nail the lie that to be on this side of the argument is to be on the political right. I fought the 1975 referendum behind my then leader, the late and great Right Honourable Tony Benn, and it's in memory of him that I'm standing here this evening. Tony Benn won us the right to have a referendum in 1975. And this I must say, but for Nigel Farage, we would not be having a referendum on this question. I want to nail the lie that being a member of the European Union has anything to do with left. As my friend for nearly 40 years, though she was obviously a child then, Kate Hoey, pointed out, what's left about TTIP allowing American corporations to smash down the doors of the National Health Service and privatise what they like with the power of law behind them? What's left about driving down workers' wages and conditions? What's left about a situation? And you know, this I must say, I know that this is one of my differences with Nigel. I have not just respect, but love for the people of Romania. I'm the only person in this room that has published a book in the Romanian language. I even speak a little bit of Romanian. But I cannot agree to subcontract to the Romanian government the right to decide who can come and live and work in Britain, who we can deport from Britain, what level of deficit we can run in Britain, or what our foreign policy in Britain should be. That I cannot do. I want to nail the lie that to be on this side of the argument is to wallow in nationalism. As a matter of fact, I hate nationalism. I fought Scottish nationalism all my life, and I helped win the referendum in Scotland in 2014, defeating Scottish nationalism. I hope to help win this referendum in a few months' time. That's why I'm pleased to say I have yesterday, on behalf of my party, signed up as an affiliate of Grassroots Out, and I hope that the Electoral Commission will give this broadly based all-party campaign the designation of the official Out campaign. But neither am I a British nationalist. Being a Scotsman from Irish background, I can hardly be called a little Englander. There is nothing internationalist about locking yourself out of the world. There is nothing internationalist about locking yourself in, although the locks seem to have broken, into a rich man's club in a part of Europe. I want the world to be our oyster. I want to trade with the Commonwealth that we so shamefully abandoned when we joined the European Union in 1975. I want to trade with Brazil, with Russia, with India, with China, with South Africa, with Iran, where the sun is rising, not setting, and where most of the customers in the world actually live. So we will not be cutting ourselves off from anything if we leave the European Union. We will be opening ourselves to the entire world. Now that is internationalism. Now, I mentioned the Eurocrats. I was a member of the British Parliament for almost 30 years, and I woke up one morning to discover that somebody called Catherine Ashton was now my foreign minister. Like Nigel in the wonderful footage you just saw, my question was, who are you? Who elected you? Who can remove you? And I watched as this person I'd never heard of before, on our behalf, dragged us into one confrontation after another with one adversary after another. Now, to be fair, it may very well be that the British government, maybe any British government, certainly in recent years, would have taken us into those same confrontations. But at least I could have fought against that here, and Parliament could have overturned that there. And David Davis has left, a man I greatly love and respect. David Davis and I were part of an epic debate in 2014 when that genius Cameron tried to persuade us to become the air force for ISIS and Al-Qaeda and start bombing Syria. The American Air Force was warming up on the tarmac, just waiting for a rubber stamp from the British Parliament of David Cameron's point of view. But in an epic debate in which speeches changed the outcome, his speech and my speech among them changed the outcome, we defeated Cameron, and the engines had to be switched off at the Andrews Air Base, and we narrowly, by 13 votes, avoided becoming embroiled in a disaster. That's the kind of parliamentary sovereignty I believe in, and that's the kind that we can have if we leave this European Union. Now, finally, I don't want you to think that I'm any kind of pacifist against all wars. If I was alive and of age, I would have been among the first in the queue to volunteer to fight in the Second World War. Indeed, I would have been one of those agitating that we should confront fascism earlier and with all the vigor that we could then muster. But the war, when it came, was, as Mr. Churchill said, our finest hour, when we all went forward together, Mr. Churchill and Mr. Attlee and Mr. Bevan, together as one front rank, leading the British people, never as united before or since, and we wrote our name in the stars. That's what we are doing here tonight. Mr. Farage and me, Ms. Hoy and Mr. Davis, left, right, forward march to victory on the 23rd of June.